We have officially entered the AI supercycle, and everybody wants to be at the forefront of this new wave. And many analysts compared it to a gold rush. And so, you know, during a gold rush, you want to be the one selling picks and shovels.
Right. We've all heard this phrase before. During the Californian gold rush, those who sold shovels and mining supplies made more money than those who tirelessly scoured the land for gold.
Well, it all comes down to the AI tech stack, as illustrated by A16Z here. At the top of the stack are familiar apps like ChatGPT.
The middle layer boasts large language models, or LLM for short, such as GPT-4 and Llama 2.
These models are often run on cloud service providers, or CSPs, like AWS, GCP, or Azure.
And crucially, the bottom layer, compute hardware and chips. This is where semiconductors come into play, powering everything AI.
So today we are going to visualize the key players in compute hardware and chips to help you navigate this industry like a pro. And we'll touch on some major players you're probably overlooking, so stay tuned.
Hey, I'm Bertrand, founder of App Economy Insight.
And I'm Stephanie, AI product leader and creator. We are here to guide you through the semiconductor industry. It's a vast ecosystem, so let's break it down with a visual. We have Foundries, who manufactures the chips that power your favorite devices. So Taiwan Semiconductor, or TSMC, dominates with over 60% of global semiconductor production. Fabless companies such as NVIDIA and AMD are design masters, while integrated device manufacturers, or IDMs, like Samsung and Intel, handle both design and manufacturing. Then we have equipment manufacturers that provide foundries with the machinery and material needed for chip production. And finally, some companies power the entire ecosystem with tools and proprietary designs. Now, before we start, a word of caution. The semiconductor industry is a dynamic and complex landscape characterized by rapid innovation, fierce competition, and a pretty delicate balance between supply and demand. And so this can lead to fundamentals to be very volatile. And you'll often see a surge in revenue followed by collapses.
And the stock price of these companies can be just as volatile. Look, I've had AMD in my portfolio since 2017, and while I returned more than 10x so far on my investment, I had to go through hell and back. The stock went from $11 to $32, back down to $16, later it soared to $50, then to $155, crashed back down to $60, doubled in the following 6 months, crashed again. You get the idea. It's an absolute roller coaster. And this type of volatility is not for everyone.
Yeah, you really had some diamond hands during that, right? All right, so let's zoom in on some of the largest companies in the industry. So as you can see in this chart, 10 companies in the industry are worth more than $100 billion. NVIDIA's stock rose by nearly 240% in 2023, reaching a $1 trillion valuation. And if you want our take on their valuation, then check out our video on NVIDIA. Let's look at them closely. So starting with the foundries and IDMs, most of them share revenue by use cases. TSMC, the behemoth from Taiwan, is a vital cog in the global tech machine. They're manufacturing chips powering everything from smartphones to automobiles. And they're pushing the envelope with 3-nanometer technology, eyeing mass production by 2024. And they've even expanded their production capacity in the US with new plants.
Over in South Korea, Samsung plays a critical role in memory chip. Their unique GAA design, which stands for Gate All Around, is expected to make chips more competitive. Of course, Samsung also manufactures electronics from smartphones to home appliances.
Now, back in the US, Intel designs and manufactures its own chips. Intel is known for its powerful processors, particularly central processing units, or CPUs. According to Mercury Research, Intel held a 63% share of the global PC processor market in 2022 and 83% share in the server market. The company launched an initiative called AI Everywhere to bring AI to a broader range of devices and applications. Before we move on to the next category, if you like this video, yes, we are gonna ask again, smash that subscribe button and like this video.
It may not sound like much, but it really helps our video be discovered for us to keep bringing you content around tech, business, and investing. Now, let's talk about fabless companies. They focus on design and chip architectures while outsourcing manufacturing to foundries. This category includes tech giants like Apple with its M-series chip, Tesla with its Dojo supercomputer chip for autonomous driving, or Google's Tensor Processing Units, or TPUs, even Amazon with its Inferentia chips for inference and Trainium for training.
NVIDIA has been the story of 2023. While they rose to fame for their gaming graphic processing units, or GPUs, they're now a driving force in the AI revolution with chips that power the data center. There's a huge demand for generative AI, from hyperscalers to consumer internet companies like Meta to large enterprises like Adobe and Snowflake.
Take a look at the explosion in demand for NVIDIA's GPUs for data center. We've never seen anything like it. And management sees continued strong demand in the year ahead. Jensen Wong said that NVIDIA is essentially an AI foundry. They are expanding their reach with CPUs and networking solutions, and they are on track to reach $1 billion in annual run rate from services. It's a familiar story if you watched our video discussing Apple's business model, with the rising software revenue that could make NVIDIA's business more durable and predictable.
There are still other key players in this category. So Broadcom has made huge acquisitions, from Avago for $37 billion in 2016 to VMware for $61 billion in 2022.
Advanced Micro Devices, or AMD, is recognized for its high performance computing and graphic technology. It's a major competitor to Intel in the CPU market and NVIDIA in the GPU market, offering a range of processors and graphics cards for PCs, servers, and data centers. They've made strategic acquisitions like Pensando in 2021 and Xilinx in 2022. They expanded their AI team, led by Victor Peng, former Xilinx CEO. They are committed to deliver end-to-end solutions that could rival NVIDIA.
Let's not forget equipment manufacturers, the backbone of the industry, and they provide the necessary machinery and technology for chip fabrication.
ASML is a titan here. It's one of the largest European companies, and it's the only provider of extreme ultraviolet, or EUV, lithography machines. It's a key technology for producing advanced microchips. ASML is at the center of a geopolitical chess game. With pressure from the US, the Netherlands has restricted the export of EUV technology to China. This technology is critical for the most advanced chips, which is creating a geopolitical tension around the world, with countries trying to reduce their dependence on foreign technology.
It's actually pretty fascinating how international and interdependent the semiconductor and tech industry is. All right, companies like Applied Materials and Lam Research, they are the unsung heroes, providing the tools for chip fabrication.
Okay, so going back to our industry map, innovation in the category extends to design tools and intellectual property.
Synopsys, for instance, is integrating security into software development life cycles. Arm Holdings is pivotal with its chip architectures dominating mobile computing. Their design is at the heart of countless devices like the iPhone.
For more in-depth analysis and up-to-date news on the semiconductor industry, visit my website, appeconomyinsight.com. You'll find access to these charts if you want to spend more time studying them alongside my commentary.
Advancements in semiconductors are accelerating AI capabilities, but this also opens new doors for cybersecurity challenges. And after all, AI makes everyone's lives easier, right? Including hackers.
So watch next our deep dive into AI hacking. You'll learn the top 6 AI hacks emerging, including data poisoning, and how to protect yourself. So see you right there.